each session to be able to just to know a little bit about who's here and who isn't and where you're from, and it does help us very much in our statistics. So I'm just going to clear the answers on this one. Reopen it. And if you could just all just type in your answers where you're from. Lots from the USA, India, Canada, UK, UK, UK. Yana, Iran, okay, anyone else want to type in where you're from? Ireland, good, and thank you. Now I'm going to go to the next poll. And we're going to talk about what is your main occupation or role. If you choose other, please type it in the please type it in the chat box if you are an other. So as it was at the last session, we have a lot of midwifery students, midwifery manager, midwifery educators, clinical midwives, and a couple of others. Me being one of those others, I'm an other educator, not a midwife, but I do work in health and human services and as an instructional designer. Right, so oh. And now we're going to go to the final poll. And it says where are you accessing this from? Where are you coming from? International Volunteer Midwife. Thank you, Anya. Oops. Going to clear this. They're all answers. So, where are you joining the virtual International Day of the Midwife Conference from? Lots of people joining from home. Let that run through another minute. So, and there you go. So thank you very much. I'm just going to hide these now. Thank you. So I'm going to pass it over to you then, Catherine.
Okay, so I did not get another response email from Buke, but I am going to take that as an indication that we will go ahead and proceed, and as soon as she's able to join us, she can take over. So Buke Afalabe is a 38-year-old registered nurse, registered midwife and public health nurse with a bachelor's degree in nursing science. She is a senior nursing officer on the labor ward of Obafemi Awolowo University Teaching Hospital Complex, and that's in Ile, Ife, southwest Nigeria. She has a special interest in nursing and midwifery research. And as you know, there, Africa, the continent of Africa has is an area with many, many challenges in the way of good outcomes for maternal child and neonatal health. So Buca's presentation deals with issues and challenges and initiatives, the Maternal Neonatal and Child Health Initiative, which is taking place in Nigeria. Okay, so you see her outline here, but we're going to jump right into the body of her presentation. So the acronym IMNCH stands for Integrated Maternal, Neonatal, and Child Health as an integrated approach for the care of mothers, newborns, and children. And I think we would all agree that the health and well-being of the mother is inextricably linked with the health and survival of the child. And the IMNCH is in line with the United States Agency for International Development, Bureau for Global Health's flagship Maternal, Neonatal, and Child Health Program. This program focuses on reducing maternal, neonatal, and child mortality and accelerating progress towards achieving the MDGs 4 and 5.
Catherine, I think we see Buki now. I'll just bump her up to presenter.
Buki, okay. Yes, bump her up to
There you go. Buki, you have presenter status now. You just want to set up your mic. You can take over. Thank you so much.
Okay, we're still in the introduction, so you're here just in time for your brief bio.
Hello. Good afternoon. I'm Adebukola Falabi, presenting from Obafemi Awolowo University Teaching Hospital, Ile-Ife, Osun State, Nigeria. Like Catherine has started, my presentation is on integrated maternal, neonatal, and child health, IMNCH in Nigeria, issues and challenges. I will pick up from where Catherine I'll start from the introduction. Thank you very much. IMNCH, I'll pick up from where Catherine stopped. I'll continue. IMNCH, Integrated Maternal and Child Health supported programming in maternal, newborn, and child health, immunization, family planning, malaria, nutrition, and HIV/AIDS, in addition to evidence-based intervention that are likely to improve maternal, neonatal, and child health survival and nutrition. Next slide, please. Most newborn deaths in Nigeria occur within the first few weeks of life, reflecting the intimate link between the survival of the newborn and the quality of maternal care. The Integrated Maternal, Newborn, and Child Health Strategy is a Nigerian initiative. IMNCH in Nigeria. The government of Nigeria started implementing the Integrated Maternal and Child Health Strategy in the year 2007 through the Federal Ministry of Health. Nigeria's development of IMNCH is in line with the World Health Assembly resolution, which urges member states to, among other things, speed up action to ensure that maternal, newborn, and child health interventions are available everywhere. IMN Theatre in Nigeria. This strategy was put up to fast-track intervention packages that include nutritional supplements, immunization, the use of insecticide-treated nets, and prevention of mother-to-child transmission of HIV/AIDS in order to achieve the 4th and 5th MDG goals. The 4th and 5th MDG goals, as we all know, is concerned with reducing childhood mortality rate and maternal mortality rate by 2/3 and 3/4 respectively, while contributing to the achievement of Millennium Development Goal of Goal 1, which has to do with eradication of extreme poverty, Goal 6, which has to do with environmental sustainability, Goal 6, which has to do with prevention, treatment of endemic diseases, Goal 7, which has to do with environmental sustainability. IMNCA strategies addresses 6 conditions responsible for 90% of maternal death, vis-a-vis hemorrhage, infection, obstructed labor, hypertension, malaria, and anemia, as well as the most common condition responsible for over 90% of undefined mortality, like malaria, pneumonia, diarrhea diseases, measles, and the underlying contributing factors such as malnutrition and HIV/AIDS. In establishing the above, the Integrated Maternal and Child Health Strategy selected interventions with wide coverage packages, and these packages are delivered in 3 delivery modes. We have the family-oriented, community-based services. That is, you know, in most people that access healthcare in Nigeria, they are the people at the grassroots, at the local government level. So involving the family and the community in those services is part of the implementation of IMNT. Then, population-oriented outreach services, which can be scheduled, and number 3, clinical services, giving one-to-one basis. Therefore, IMNCH strategy set out to weave together all intervention that will improve maternal, newborn, and child health implementation. Before now in Nigeria, maternal, newborn, and child health intervention have been implemented as separate and individual intervention. Therefore, the Federal Ministry of Health, the government of Nigeria, discovered this gap and instituted Integrated Maternal and Child Health to bridge the gap. Guiding principles of Integrated Maternal and Child Health strategies. The principles include continuum of care, that is, care, continuity of care. Then it involves integration of proposed priority intervention. Proposed priority intervention, women and child rights, rights-based planning to ensure the protection of the most vulnerable. The most vulnerable category in Nigeria include the mothers, the pregnant women, the newborn, and the children. And part of the principle has to do with equity, ensuring that mothers, newborn, and child, they have equal access to, and they have a universal coverage to, quality of health care for enhanced maternal, newborn, and child survival. Part of the guiding principles involve multi-sectoral collaboration with other sectors required to achieve health outcome and development. The sectoral, apart from the federal ministry, collaborating with other ministries in the Federation of Nigeria, like the agricultural ministry, the judiciary ministry, to work hand in hand for the towards achievement of this integrated maternal and child health, as well as partnership, partnering with non-organization, non-governmental organization to promote synergy of effort and action that leverages resources and avoid wastage and duplication. Why do we have to consider integrated maternal and child health in Nigeria? Why is it important in Nigeria? Nigeria is Africa's most populous country with estimated population of 178 million 516,904 inhabitants as of July 2014. That's why Nigeria is regarded as the giant of Africa. And one out of every five Nigerians of five Africa is in Nigeria. Nigeria has 23% women of childbearing age, 20% children under 5, crude birth rate of 40.6 per 1,000, and total fertility rate of 5.7. The country loses about 2,300 children under 5 of age, and about 145 women of childbearing age every day to preventable diseases and pregnancy-related causes. Out of every five children born alive in Nigeria, one dies before their fifth birthday. This presents about 10% of the global total. Majority of these under five deaths occur at home. And annually, an estimated 52,900 Nigerian women die from pregnancy-related complications. This is about 10% of the total global maternal death indices. A woman's chance of dying from pregnancy and childbirth in Nigeria is about 1 in 13. Nigeria is the second largest contributor to under 5 mortality rate and maternal mortality ratio in the world. Improving care for pregnant women, however, improving care for pregnant women, newborn and children at home in their health facility has far effect on their health and development in addition to reduction in sickness and death. And as we all know that there is intricate link between mothers, newborn and children, and because of this link, their care requires an integrated approach. The goal of IMNCH in Nigeria. The goal is to pull together an evidence-based maternal neonatal child health framework in a practical continuum in order to reduce maternal, neonatal, and child mortality so as to achieve the United Nations Development Goal 4 and 5. The goal is targeted towards achieving 75% and 65% reduction in maternal mortality and under 5 rates respectively. And it was hoped that integrated approach will improve the delivery of maternal, newborn and child health services better than previous approaches based on separate efforts. The vision of INNCH.
Catherine, you want to pop in again? Seem to have lost our presenter.
Grab my headset back. Okay, so the vision of the IMNCH is to ensure that in Nigeria, pregnancy and delivery do not pose a threat to the lives of mother and the newborn, that children are healthy and able to grow, and develop to their full potential, thereby contributing to the nation's socioeconomic development. And there are 7 strategic objectives to the IMNCH. Remember, this is an integrated strategy. 1, improve access to good quality health services. 2, ensure adequate provision of medical supplies, drugs, bundled vaccines, reproductive health commodities, and insecticide-treated nets and other basic equipment. Now, those of you who were on, you know, for the previous session were Yale students were talking about access in Laos. Okay, Buki's back. I'm going to let her take over now. Buki, do you have a mic?
Apology for the break was due to internet problem. Objective of integrated maternal and child health strategy. There are 7 strategic objectives, and they are, the objective is to improve access to good quality health services, to ensure adequate provision of medical supplies, drugs, bundled vaccine, reproductive health commodity, and insecticide-treated net, and other basic equipment, Part of the objective is to strengthen individual, family, and community capacity to take necessary action at home and to seek health care in a timely manner, to improve capacity for organization and management of maternal and child health services, then establishing a financing mechanism that ensures adequate funding, affordability, equity, and efficient use of funds from the various sources. Strengthening supervision, of this program. Strengthening supervision, monitoring, and evaluation system to report ongoing progress towards the maternal and child health MDGs, and to establish and sustain partnership to support implementation of IMNCH strategy. Implementation of
Buki, we've lost your microphone. Are you having an internet connection issue again?
She's still in the room, though, so let's give her a minute. Whoops.
Nope. We just lost her. I'll keep an eye on her in the participants if you just want to pick.
Okay. So she talks about the different levels of government that the IMNCH is being implemented at, and that would be federal, state, and local. And the existing intervention packages are being revised as necessary so as to implement high impact interventions at all levels. Oh, here she is back again. All right. Lorraine, do you see her down there in the participant window?
Yes, but I was having trouble grabbing her, so there we go.
Okay. All right. So Buki is back.
Oh, Whenever you're ready, Buki.
The primary health is a structure for the implementation of integrated maternal and child health strategy. And this is being done through the minimum world healthcare packages at this level has been developed by the Primary Healthcare Development Agency. You know, in Nigeria, we have the federal, the state, and the local government. At the local government, that is the grassroots where we have people who access healthcare. And within this local government, we have, the local government is divided into different wards. So for this full implementation of this IMNH, National Primary Healthcare Development developed minimum ward healthcare package so that this implementation, people at the ward get direct access to it. Some of the intervention of the strategy are also being implemented at the referral facility level. Priority actions for IMNCH. There are three priority actions for integrated maternal and child health strategy. We have the pregnancy care. Under the pregnancy care, we have the focus antenatal care. And the activities under the focus antenatal care include the giving of TT immunization to the pregnant women, screening the pregnant women, and management of syphilis and other sexually transmitted diseases. During the pregnancy care, we discover patients with preeclampsia and appropriate management are being instituted. Then, during this antenatal care, we give intermittent preventive treatment, that is IPT, the use of anti-malaria for pregnant women, and it's being given to them during the second trimester. So before a woman delivers, the woman has two doses of these IPTs. And during antenatal care, insecticide-treated mosquito nets are being given to pregnant women so as to prevent malaria diseases. And also at the antenatal care, there is prevention of mother-to-child transmission of HIV/AIDS. During this period, we do voluntary counseling tests to pregnant women and we counsel them on the need for them to be tested to have their HIV status done. And those who are positive by chance are being referred to the Institute of Human Virology of Nigeria unit of the hospital. Part of the priority action for integrated maternal neonatal child health is the childbirth care. During the childbirth care, first level of delivery care, the patients are being managed through the use of pantograph. Active management of labor is being undergone, as well as active management of first stage of labor in order to prevent postpartum hemorrhage. Then injectable antibiotics as a prophylaxis in order to prevent infection, and the use of magnesium sulfate in the treatment of preeclampsia ranging from mild to severe. Then during the childbirth care, we have backup emergency maternal obstetrics and neonatal care, including the use of vacuum extraction, manual removal of placenta, manual vacuum aspiration. There is also backup comprehensive emergency care for obstetric neonatal care, including all function plus cesarean section where necessary, as well as blood transfusion. At the childbirth, we have under the childbirth again, we have the care for the newborn care, and this includes immediate newborn care, that is, which involves thermal protection, cord care, access breathing, initiation of exclusive breastfeeding, prevention of infection, then active neonatal resuscitation where necessary. And during this newborn care, information are given to the delivered mother on home care, breastfeeding, hygiene, and advice are being given to them, usually at discharge, signs of emergency, and follow-up. They are also being counseled on the importance of immunization for their newborn, and immunization is being given according to the national guideline. Then, late neonatal period, we have exclusive breastfeeding, whereby you educate a delivered mother, a nursing mother, to exclusive breastfeed for the first 6 months without giving water or any other thing, and to continue with complementary feeding until 2 years of age. Then we teach them, we educate them on importance of appropriate hygiene, then recognition of danger signs during puerperium, as well as prevention and management of any form of illness during puerperium. At the childhood, the priority action during the childhood period, we engage in integrated management of childhood illness, and there have been guidelines to follow in the treatment of these childhood illnesses. Then prevention of management of childhood illnesses and care of HIV exposed children. HIV exposed children are being admitted into the special neonatal unit, and immediately they are delivered, they are being given antiretroviral drugs. Then we have immunization during childhood up to 2 years, then nutrition intervention. So that nutrition intervention also enhance their growth. Then we also have education on water, sanitation, and hygiene. Although we have not gotten to where we're going when it comes to implementation of this IM, integrated maternal and child health in Nigeria, however, we have some certain achievements that have been achieved so far, and this includes reduction in maternal mortality ratio from 545 deaths per 100,000, from 800 deaths per 100,000 to 545 deaths per 100,000. Then we have reduction through the implementation of integrated neonatal, maternal, and child health. There has been reduction in under 5 mortality rate, 157 deaths per 1,000 from 201 deaths per 1,000. There has also been reduction in infant mortality rate, and it has been reduced to 75% death per 1,000. Although we have not gotten to there, but we believe with full implementation we will get there. Part of the achievement through the implementation of integrated maternal and child health in Nigeria involved improved human resources at the primary health care level through the midwifery service scheme. The midwifery service scheme involved the employment of newly graduated midwives, either from basic school of midwifery, as a postgraduate student from school of nursing, or as a graduate from the university. They are being employed for 1 year. They are being deployed to rural areas in the community to take care of mother, newborn, and the child. Recently, through the implementation of integrated maternal and child health, about 4,000 midwives, also community extension workers, are being deployed to the primary health care facilities. Not just deploying those people to the community, there are also being capacity building for these midwives in life-saving skills, as well as training in integrated maternal management of childhood illness to enhance their performance so as to provide quality care. And as part of the implementation, there have been upward review of numbers of admission into schools of midwifery in Nigeria, and there has been strengthening supply of reproductive, maternal, neonatal and child health commodity. Also, procurement of anti-shock garments in the prevention of postpartum hemorrhage. Part of the achievement so far is procurement and training of health workers in the use of magnesium sulfate in order to prevent complications from pre-eclampsia as well as eclampsia, and also the use of misoprostol in order to prevent postpartum hemorrhage. As part of the achievement, there are the distribution of midwifery kits to the midwife in the rural area. These midwifery kits consist of consumables that are necessary, that are important for them to use in the rural area. And there has also been free distribution of contraceptive commodity in order to prevent unwanted pregnancies. Part of this achievement is procurement and distribution of antiretroviral drugs. This is readily available in most parts of Nigeria. Once a woman is being diagnosed retroviral positive, the patient is being referred to the Institute of Human Virology Unit of the unit of the hospital, and the patient's viral load is being assessed. A patient with high viral load is being commenced on antiretroviral drug, and the use of artemisinin combined therapies for the treatment of malaria in the rural area. Part of the achievement is health financing national health insurance scheme. National health insurance scheme, we have the national health insurance scheme at the federal level. This has been moved to the community, whereby somebody, a market woman, an artist can benefit from this insurance. This community-based health insurance are in some states in part of the country. Part of our achievement is the Millennium Development Goal Conditional Grant Scheme. And we have improved the improved budgetary allocation to health in Nigeria has been increased from 5%, which is in 2006, has been increased to 7% in 2011. Then we have research priorities implementation. Research priority implementation of research projects on prevention of mother-to-child transmission, maternal and neonatal child health are currently going on in Nigeria. However, despite these achievements, there are lots of challenges we've been facing, and part of these challenges are insufficient health system capacity because of our large population, fragmented responsibility, then availability of quality of services. We still have challenges in that area. Then access and utilization of services. There are still areas in the rural, there are still places in the rural area where people are still finding access very difficult. Then we have insufficient human resources. Despite the midwifery service scheme, the human resources is not yet enough. Then poor knowledge and practice at the house level. And more overall, there has not been enough community participation. Because of the highlighted challenges, here are the following recommendations as well as call to action towards full implementation of my integrated maternal and child health in Nigeria. At the state level, The we have started it, but continuity to maintain continuity, providing a provision of adequate funds for maternal and child health, improving access to healthcare delivery, ensuring quality health services are available, functioning and affordable for family in the state, educating the girl child, which is the goal 2 of the Millennium Development Goal. Instituting a health team with capacity to plan, implement, and supervise a state health plan of action. Ensuring that health facilities are available, appropriately equipped, functioning, and they are affordable for families in the states. Providing skilled health workers, distributing them equitably, especially to the rural area, then facilitating a two-way referral. A two-way referral is such that if a woman needs to be referred to a higher health facility, she'll be able to be referred there and be referred back to the referral center. Then motivating health workers in rural and hard to reach areas. At the local government level, because our system of government we have at the federal, at the state, at the local government level, instituting a local government health team with capacity to plan, implement, and supervise a local government area health plan of action. Providing functioning, affordable health facility in rural and hard-to-reach community in order to improve the physical and financial access. Facilitating easy evacuation of emergency cases to hospitals where they can be properly treated. Aside the rural area, then ensuring that newborn and children are registered and they are appropriately immunized in order to prevent this childhood illnesses, as well as provision of safe water. We have safe water, but they are not adequate. So we hereby recommend that provision of safe water and ensuring adequate sanitation in the communities. In conclusion, the quality of health care that both mother and newborn receive during pregnancy, at delivery, and in the postnatal period is very essential to ensuring women remain healthy and that children get a strong start. In Nigeria, however, there is now high political commitment to improve maternal, newborn, and child health, evidenced by the initiation and implementation of the health sector reform, as well as the recent passage of National Health Bill in Nigeria that has just been passed is another landmark achievement in Nigeria, which is a great step forward in achieving the integrated maternal, newborn, and child health objectives. The bill, in addition to defining clear roles and responsibilities for the 3 tiers of government and the enactment of the basic health care insurance scheme, provides for the establishment of primary health care development fund with explicit pronouncement, procurement on how the fund will be utilized. All this will greatly help in putting integrated maternal and child health in Nigeria in place. Finally, full implementation of integrated maternal and child health in Nigeria will prevent up to 72% neonatal death, more than 70% under 5 death, and two-thirds representing 62% maternal death. That is, in absolute terms, if integrated maternal and child health in Nigeria is fully implemented, about more than 200,000 mothers and 6 million lives can be saved by 2015 if full attention is directed towards full implementation of integrated maternal and child health in Nigeria. Thanks for listening.
have questions for Buki?
The attendees are still typing, waiting for their question. Yes, to support international midwifery community.
That's a great question, Buki. So how can the international midwifery community support you in what you're doing? You've got us here.
Yes, I'm getting you. International midwifery community who will be supported in Nigeria. This could be supported through advocacy to our government to further encourage midwives, motivation of midwives in the country through advocacy. Yes, the training of the 4,000 midwives were not done at one time. They were done in batches and at different states. There are 36 states in Nigeria. And at different times at different states to the different geopolitical zones in Nigeria. But the total estimates at the time were 4,000 midwives. Aside the midwives that are working, the 4,000 midwives, they were the one trained. They are the one trained through the midwifery service scheme to offer services at the rural area. These numbers, they are different from the midwives working either at the state level or at the federal hospitals. Yes, the autonomy of Nigerian midwife is being questioned, especially at the federal level. But recently, there has been capacity building training midwife on how to be a good ward manager, training them to build their capacity to man their capacity. But however, most teaching hospitals, the autonomy of midwife are being queried. However, at the state and at the local government, the midwife has autonomy to perform their responsibility within their scope of service. Yes, we have. There are two types of midwifery training in Nigeria. Becca, I can see your question. There are two types of training in Nigeria. Three types of training. We have the basic midwifery training, whereby students come in after secondary school into 3 years basic midwifery training. We also have post-basic midwifery training. After being qualified as a registered nurse, you go for post-basic midwifery training, which is 18 months training is 18 months duration. Then at the university level, as part of the certificate to be acquired at the degree level, the midwifery training is also being inculcated. Yes, Jenny. Yes, I talk about motivation, that midwives should be motivated through capacity building, in-service training, provision of midwifery kits, then empowerment, autonomous. And this is our request from the federal government of Nigeria.
I'm afraid we're going to have to call this to an end now. This has been absolutely wonderful. Let's give Buki a big round of applause.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, and thank you for trying and keep coming back, even though our technology was messing up. We do need to move on to get ready for the next session.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. I'm very grateful, and I'm happy to be part of this great international conference. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Buki. And here's her references. And I'm just going to...